Welcome to our living room. Thank you so much for joining me today. We're going to be talking a little bit about the intersection of technology and healthcare. COVID has been this huge catalyst for change. And I guess the question is, what have you seen being one of the biggest technological changes over this 2-year period, maybe locally at your hospitals, but also globally? What does that look like?
Like you said, COVID was a catalyst and it really forced change upon people. Mm. One of the things was collaboration across hospitals, but also internationally as well. Everybody realized that we have this enormous brand trust internationally, and that if we actually collaborate together, you can propel things forward a lot quicker.
And I guess, Mum, then to that perspective, how have you found sort of the changing dynamic in the way you, I guess, collaborate with your team?
I'm very old school and, you know, actually used to use paper, which is, you know, but I think technology's here to stay. Microsoft Teams allowed us to actually have secure and safe collaboration. And from a team point of view, it was really revolutionary. You know, we often walk around with a bit of paper with patients' names on it, and being able to sort of have that on a Teams platform rather than caring about, you know, patient papers and stickers was fantastic for us.
When you look at all of your daily processes and your workflows, technology can play such a big part in that, and I think it's really now starting to. And I guess for you, Caitlin, being a junior doctor, using technology, is it something that's a part of your workflow at the moment?
You know, you're always really busy, and I always sort of say that if you're trying to bring something in new for junior doctors, it's got to be more efficient than the last thing that you're doing. If it's better than the last version, then they will take it up in a heartbeat.
I think also from a device perspective, one of the really interesting things that both of you interact with a lot is telehealth. How has that evolved over the sort of last year, and what does that look like now?
It's definitely improved.
Yeah.
But a really amazing thing I've seen being taken up really only across the last year or so is that we've been getting patients to go to their general practitioner who have set up telehealth clinics where they could then connect to the specialist. And it's nice to see as well the general practitioners often come in and talk to you, and that's a really nice continuity of care.
It's so powerful now that you're able to connect not only with other doctors, but yeah, with patients who are otherwise probably not able to receive medical care. If we do walk down that ideal road and we have a think about what healthcare might look like with a device in hand, how would something like that look in sort of your day-to-day, Caitlin?
The real benefit to having an individual device is that we are across so many different parts of the hospital.
Yeah.
So that's going to increase your efficiency.
Yeah.
But it also means that you could then store on that device securely things that are important to you and your patients.
From your perspective, Mum, obviously you're running the shop a lot of the time. Is a device pertinent to you?
So dialing in at a big meeting, sometimes the audio stuff is really difficult.
Yeah.
If I had my own device, I'd just dial in my, because you know, you can hear a lot better. But having a tablet that you can draw on, so at the moment I draw on a piece of paper and it would be fantastic to be able to draw the picture for them. And again, if that could then be saved in their patient chart would be fabulous. And I think the most important thing with technology is if they talk to each other. We just need to make sure that it all continues to integrate.
From the sort of ink to text perspective, is being able to have sort of something where you can draw and you can pass that information to them really quickly and easily, is that something that is useful? Is that something that you would make use of sort of in your day to day?
A drawing function would be so helpful, not just for patient communication, like Mum said, but also for communication with your own team or to other practitioners as well. Being able to draw a face and where the skin lesion is, and that to go into their chart is really important for continuity of care.
You know, I guess that's a very ideal future. As both of you know, I'm moving into a new role next year. And obviously, as healthcare is a passion of mine, maybe I'll try and align with that as sort of my industry vertical. And I wanted to ask, while we're here, have we got any bright ideas?
A single system to be able to access everything about your patient would be really helpful.
You need to be able to see patterns.
Yeah.
And we have so much data, but it's really hard for us to access that data. Certainly in health, that could push us along, I think, a bit further if we
Absolutely.
Had a simple way to be able to pull that out and to see the pattern.
Yep. Absolutely, I think the future of the big data wave as it sort of starts to crest. You know, the world is definitely changing and I think we've got some exciting things coming. I think that's probably us wrapped up, but I wanted to say thank you to the both of you for coming along and chatting today. And yeah, thank you for teaching me everything I know.